So what is your name, sir?
Anil Menon.
And could you tell us a little bit about what you'll be reading today? Or tomorrow, the whole week?
Kind of a stub of a short story. Something about a line that likes to classify people under categories.
That sounds good.
If that doesn't produce a chill, I don't know what will.
My own novel's mistress's crisis and my latest one, Queen of Dreams, fall into this category where the world seems unusual. The world seems more than what we think it is. And Queen of Dreams, which is about a dream interpreter, and her daughter, who tries to figure out what it is that her mother does, which allows her access into this other world, which Rocky, the daughter, cannot access herself, is deals with this. It's a great time to be a South Asian writer, and to that I would add, it's a great time for readers of South Asian writing, and I hope you agree with me.
Opportunity to have exposure to so many South Asian authors. It's not something that you get to have on a day-to-day basis, and it's both inspiring and humbling.
I want to be an India abroad kind of Indian. MIT graduate at 20, Yale JD by 21, running for Congress, running for governor, always running, Republican, naturally, staunchly pro-family, but anti-gun control. Yes, enforced right-wing morality and free choice of weaponry are what make this country great. And if my parents could come here with $50 in traveler's checks, work 16 hours a day for 5 years to buy their own motel, so they could work 18 hours a day for the next 20 years, then why can't all those scholars get off their lazy backs? Stop breathing like rats on government handout, because free enterprise and the right to work your ass off without a safety net are what make this country.
I'm Ravi Shankar. I'm a poet in residence at Central Connecticut State University and the founding editor of the International Online Journal of the Arts, DrunkenBoat.com. And it's been a fabulous experience so far. I'm a little hoarse because I've been on four straight panels. But just the range and diversity of the artists represented here has been very exciting to see, certainly.
We are living in such nationalistic war years right now. And we turn to these books for solace, for inspiration, for a reminder that we are not solely individuals, desperately alone in our heads, but we are all connected by a common humanity. We're reminded that we can talk to each other. These writers are writing to and for each other as much as for their audience, continuing this great conversation about identity and ethnicity, gender and race, the tug of family and the desire for the other. The sometimes heart-wrenching division between the needs of one's family and the needs of one's heart.
I'm really grateful to all the people who put together Kriti. You know, this is a time when South Asian literature and art is really being appreciated. And I know as a writer myself, it's been something that I've wanted to see for years and years, so thank you.